worried about him.
I think he likes you.
So once again, this match is for the WCW Australia Hardcore title. Coming to the ring first, the challenger, weighing 233 pounds, from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, the Hellraiser, Jason Helton.
In this ring in the form of Jason Helton. Looks like he's setting him up for the super kick. Helton moves out of the way. Well scouted. Comes around with a chair shot to the side there. Ah, chair shot to the back and the back of the head.
I don't care how big you are. When bits of metal hit you in the back of the head, you're going down.
And Tavern is certainly finding that out right now. Back in the back with a huge chop. Did you hear that one?
Josh Mars was forced back by the volume.
Ah, oh, there's another one.
Even my chest is beginning to hurt.
These guys, did you see him land? Did you see him land?
It wasn't pretty.
Oh my God.
If I was a gymnastics scorer, that would be
got it. I don't know what the hell that thing was Tavern brought out with him, but the Helton's got it now and he's gonna use it.
I believe that's the tribal warping stick.
Ah! And he just snapped it across the back. He just snapped that right across the back of Ray Tavern. Oh my God, the violence is certainly starting early. These guys are determined to make use of any foreign object they can find.
And once again, people, do not try this at home. Unless you want to look like Ray Tavern.
Elton's calling for the audience. He's getting a good response, I might add. I wasn't sure how he'd fare. Obviously, Jason Helton, you know, is generally a wrestler in the Sydney promotions. He's here facing, I guess, a local via the US in Grey Tavern.
Those wrestlers already limping
to the ring. Rolling Tavern back into the ring now. He's looking hurt, that's for sure. There's a stomp to the side. He's really working him over now. He's got the chair, he's got the American flag chair there. Oh, and I guess he's showing him what he thinks of America with that shot. He's sitting on, he's trying to set it on the angle, trying to set it, He decided not to waste time with it and just dropped it straight down.
That's the core taking the direct approach. And that's the Hellraiser. The crowd are enjoying it. He doesn't like them though.
The crowd seems to like him, he seems to not like him. Oh, there he goes, drops him down. It's a move that I believe is known as the Midnight Rider. The Tavern just hit him there. Helton is certainly looking at it there.
The Tavern's going under the ring. What could be down there?
What the hell is he doing?
It's a wooden sawhorse. What is a wooden sawhorse? There's two of them. What a sawhorse. Is there a construction team underneath that?
What is going on here? What is going on here?
And it's a sheet of wood.
He's setting up his own table. It's not enough for him to bring out a table. He's decided to make one of his own.
He's a very DIY guy.
He certainly is. That's what we're seeing here. We've got fans of do-it-yourself in the audience here tonight.
Couple of home renovators.
They're both on the ring. They're both on the side there. Jason Elton's working them over and shot. Both of them come back. That looked like a side rushing leg sweep almost off the side of the ring through the table.
And there's no matting outside the ring here.
It's straight onto the carpet, I guess. I hope we don't
have to, concrete underneath.
I hope we don't have to pay to get this carpet clean. Oh my god. They both went through that table. That was a side Russian leg sweep, I believe executed by Grady Tavern with Jason Helton off the side of the ring through the table.
And Tavern's throwing Helton back into the ring.
Helton certainly hurt after that. Tavern's
got
something
cracking his chest. I don't know what he's got cracking.
Tavern struggles over. He goes for the cover. That's still only a two count. Sorry, I was a little worried I was on fire again there for a second. I guess he's in the corner.
I guess we can sit back down there.
He's stomping the feet. Helton's staggering. He misses his head. Comes behind. Drops him down into the crossface. The Kevlar crossface.
Josh Bowers is asking the question.
Jason Helton, of course, is student of Stu Hart's dungeon. Chris Benoit, the man who made this whole fight famous. Another graduate there. In fact, I understand those two are good friends. Helton certainly showing the move off to its fullest there and wrenching back on the form of Grey Tavern.
And Grey Tavern refusing to submit. He's just taking the pain and he's powering himself up to his feet.
He's right up to his feet. There's an elbow there in the midsection. See how easily he picks Helton up. Ah, and he drops him around. He drops him around. Helton is down and down hard. Tavern is climbing over. He struggles over for the two count, two and a half count, I believe, on that one. Oh my god, both of these guys are hurt.
Have a look around the ring, Mr. J. The demolition site.
It's gotta be, really, it's almost getting to the point now that it's coming down to stamina. And, I mean, I'm sorry, but if it comes down to stamina, I'm gonna have to go with Jason Helton. Both of these guys have taken a beating. Both of these guys, I'm sure, are probably gonna take more of a beating. At the moment, Tavern is setting up outside
the table.
He's setting up outside again as Helton struggles to his feet. Tavern's climbing back to the ring. Helton's caught him coming in, caught him on the ropes. Helton's turned him. He's hitting him with those short shots to the side of the head and to the back of the head. Oh, he went for the suplex.
He blocked it.
He managed to block it. The Hellraiser blocked it. He's coming back. Ah! He hit him with, I guess, some people call it a Yakuza kick. We're going to call it an organized crime kick here tonight. And Tavern went flying off the side of the ring through that table.
And Helton looks pretty happy with himself. He's got a sore back, he's got sore ribs, but he's pretty pleased.
Certainly a few pro-Canadian fans in the audience tonight.
And he's laying the boot in the Tavern.
He's stomping down on him, that's for sure.
He's picked up the table.
And he breaks the board across the back, the massive back of Grave Tavern.
He's asking for something from the audience.
What's he got?
He's got the rest of that whomping stick.
Oh my, and he's probably yes indeed. I believe that's actually a whacking stick.
Whacking, whomping, whatever it is, Grave Tavern's getting it.
He's calling for a reaction and he's getting it. Tavern's slow to get to his feet. He's certainly hurt. Helton's looking hurt too. He comes down with that chair shot across the back.
Oh,
it's a big end. Where the hell did that garbage can come from?
He had a garbage can in his pocket.
He did not have a garbage can in his pocket.
It came out of his pocket.
I don't know where it came from, but he came up with that garbage can.
Maybe he kept it in his gums like a chipmunk.
He's working it right into the corner now, right in front of the fans. Helton drops him up, drops him down, right onto our ringside barricade. This is certainly, I mean, have these guys really been in the ring at any point in this match for any length of time? They're working to the fans. And he hits that shot right across the chest, hurting his own hands in the process.
People in the front row certainly getting value for money.
And another shot a la Ric Flair.
Ric Flair's got nothing on this guy.
Oh, and Tavern goes straight into the corner post. Helton staggering around. He's saying that the hardcore build is his. It looks to me like he's looking for another weapon or looking for something.
Helton's helping Tavern back into the ring. Gonna dish out some more punishment.
Tavern is down and Tavern is hurt. At this stage, it's looking all Helton.
Look at Helton, he's limping. He's holding his back.
Helton's backing Tavern and he's hitting him again with those chops. He looks like he's trying to work the air out of him at the moment. Helton splashes him with the elbow, misses it, and there's that super kick the Tavern has been trying to hit, and he connects, possibly a little low due to fatigue, but certainly more than enough to knock the air out of the Hellraiser and knock him down to the mat.
It's the injured abdomen. He just kicked the injured abdomen.
He looks like he's going, he's bouncing off the ropes there, and that's the move that he calls the Man of Steel. And he flew like Superman with that one.
Did you see that ring bounce?
It's like I'm watching an episode of Smallville. He's going up top. Come on, he's going up top, everybody. Let's hear it for Tavern. Tavern's up top. And there's the big elbow. He's down, he's down, he's covering him. Oh, about two and a half. I believe if he hooked the leg on that one, he might have had him. Look at Helton, back to his feet. He's got him up, he's got him in that cradle suplex. He's got him up, he's got him over. Almost a fisherman suplex there. He let go, he didn't go for the pin from hooking the leg. It looks like he's trying to crawl over there and take advantage of it now. He's crawled over, he's got the arm over him. Two count only once again. Couple of fans in the audience calling Josh Mars on his count there. He's rolling Tavern into the corner and hitting him with those multiple Canadian-style stomps. He's got the chair now as well. He's laying the chair on him. I don't know what he's setting him up for here. Ah! He takes that chair right to the face. Right to the face. He's setting the chair up. I don't know what he's trying for now. Helton's staggering around. He's got him up. Oh, he looks like he's setting him up for his finish move. That's the Gravedigger right on the chair. He's going for the cover. And that's a three. Oh my God. ECW. 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 ECW.
Ladies
and gentlemen, the winner of the ECW Streetfight match and still WCW Australia Hardcore Champion, ladies and gentlemen.